Today, I want to share with you the stories of glamorous and powerful celebrities who have beat their PCOS and pregnancy struggles. Their stories are an inspiration and a reminder to us that we too can overcome our condition and live our best life. Hi, my name is Despina Pavlou and I'm the founder of PCOS Oracle, where I talk about all things PCOS and how to reverse it naturally. So if that's what you're looking for, then consider subscribing. And don't forget to hit that notification bell to be notified when I upload a new video. So today's video is a little bit different from my usual informative research science-based kind of videos. As I said, I'll be delving into the stories of celebrity women who have PCOS and have overcome it. So I'm breaking down how they went about reversing their symptoms, you know, their pregnancy struggles, as a source of inspiration for you and motivation to keep you going. And to remind you that overcoming PCOS is possible, and you shouldn't, and you're not alone in this world. We're all here to support, to raise awareness about PCOS, and we're all in this together. So a PCOS diagnosis has brought pain and sadness to many women, even those who you admire or aspire to be, because PCOS does not discriminate. But you are not alone, and you shouldn't let your PCOS diagnosis take away from you who you are. So let's get straight into the video and let me share with you the first celebrity on our list. Number one is Jillian Michaels. Jillian Michaels is a personal trainer, television personality, author and businesswoman based in Los Angeles. At 5'2.5" and a body weight of 52.16 kilograms, Jillian doesn't meet your stereotypical PCOS diagnosis. She's lean and fit, but not all women with PCOS meet this stereotypical image of being overweight or obese. However, Jillian did not always have this lean and toned look that everyone dreams to have. Her parents' divorce resulted in her gaining weight and reaching her heaviest weight of 175 pounds at the age of 12. Matters became worse for Jillian as she was teased and bullied about her weight, and this resulted in her losing her confidence. Jillian started training at the gym at the age of 17, and fitness became a sort of escapism for her. Fitness soon became a huge part of her life. Jillian wanted to positively impact others and therefore became a fitness trainer at university. Her clients' progress motivated her and pushed her even more to achieve her goals. In 2004, Jillian received her biggest break. She became a fitness trainer and strength coach on the hit TV show The Biggest Loser.
This is where it all starts. This is your last chance workout.
Last chance workout?
Ah!
You scared now?
Her appearance on the show made her a household name and a figure in the fitness industry. With her newfound fame, she was able to impact even more people on a larger scale. She released fitness DVDs and books. Jillian has openly spoken about her PCOS and pregnancy struggles when she was questioned about having children. During an interview, she said she wanted to adopt rather than conceive. When Jillian was prompted further about why she wanted to adopt, she said that she couldn't handle doing that to her body.
And it's my fault because I wasn't 100% transparent, and it became misconstrued as, oh, Jillian thinks pregnancy will ruin a body, when the truth is that since I was 16, I've had PCOS and endometriosis, which is one of the reasons that I wrote Master Your Metabolism about hormones. But I felt, and I'm not suggesting anyone should feel any shame about it. Personally for me, it was something that I felt a bit ashamed about, and I was worried about judgment, that people would think, oh, if you're so healthy, you can't have a baby. There's something wrong with you.
The media published the story, making it out that Jillian didn't want to give birth to a baby because of the effects it will have on her body.
It was a miscommunication because it came out like, oh, I don't want, I'm vain and don't want to mess up my body.
Well, the Huffington Post created a fake headline and they said, Jillian Michaels says pregnancy ruins a body, which wasn't even in the article.
Jillian later explained that her reluctance was because she had to take medications and go through medical treatment in order to have a pregnancy. And she explained that that's what she was not ready for yet. In May 2012, Jillian adopted her then 2-year-old daughter from Haiti, and within the same month, her ex-fiancé, Heidi Rose, gave birth to their son. Next on our list is Victoria Beckham. P. Heat sweat is one of the leading causes of infertility in women. But as we'll see throughout this video, it's still possible to have a pregnancy even if you have PCOS. There are women just like Victor Rebecca who have managed to overcome their PCOS and pregnancy struggles. After giving birth to their three boys, David and Victoria were eager to have a daughter. And this is where PCOS posed struggles for them. Now, after a routine checkup, Victoria Beckham's doctor explained to her that her chances of having another child decreased since having her first child. A source from Now magazine explained that Victoria Beckham's difficulty conceiving was due to her PCOS and her irregular periods. Victoria tried to gain weight in hopes that it would help her PCOS and her pregnancy. So here's the thing, a low body fat percentage can impact our menstrual cycle. Victoria's diet was healthy, full of fresh fruit and vegetables to help maintain her slender figure. However, to help her regulate her period, Victoria included more nutrient-dense carbohydrate foods. Because here's the thing, an adequate amount of good quality carbohydrates is important for our menstrual cycle. Despite her PCOS, her regular periods, and her decreased likelihood of falling pregnant after 30, Victoria successfully gave birth to her daughter Harper in 2011. Dame Emma Thompson, DBE, is the next celebrity on our list. She's one of Britain's most admired actresses who sadly endured years of agony while on her journey to become a mother. Dame Emma sadly suffered two miscarriages. Now, speaking about one's struggles is never easy, but Dame Emma openly shares her struggle with infertility and depression. Getting pregnant with PCOS may pose some difficulty, but Dame Emma and her husband Greg never gave up and decided to undergo IVF. And the couple successfully conceived with IVF, and Dame Emma gave birth to her daughter Gaia.
Sasha Peterson
is the next celebrity on our list. Sasha is a South African-born American actress and singer-songwriter. Through sharing her story, she hopes it will shed light on PCOS, a common yet overlooked condition. The downside of being a celebrity in the public eye is the gossip and the negative comments. And unfortunately, celebrities with PCOS like Sasha have been made to feel awful about their weight. During her appearance on the show Dancing with the Stars in 2017, viewers commented on Sasha's weight gain and the media ran with headlines.
And they were like, well, maybe she's pregnant. And then it turned into more of stop eating donuts and you're so fat and you're huge.
After receiving frequent abuse and just upsetting comments, Sasha opened up about her PCOS and her weight gain. Sasha explained how she was baffled on matters around her health and was unaware of what was causing her weight gain.
So I went to a bunch of different doctors and they basically just told me, oh, you'll level out, it's fine. And I ended up gaining over 70 pounds and I finally just was like, this is not normal.
Sasha visited various doctors to discover what was going on, but every doctor's answer and response was, everything's fine. But deep down, Sasha knew something was wrong, so she continued until she got the answer she was looking for. Sasha's weight gain was a result of her PCOS, and once she realized what was making her gain weight, she was able to make the necessary changes to overcome it. Sasha manages her PCOS through diet and exercises. She follows a healthy lifestyle, eats healthy, and exercises 4 to 5 times a week. And while on the show, Dancing with the Stars, she lost 37 pounds. Daisy Ridley is the next celebrity on our list. Social media often do not portray reality, with most concerned about creating a picture-perfect life, but not Daisy Ridley. There are many celebrities with PCOS, like Daisy Ridley, who uses their influence and social media following, their last social media following, to address their very own PCOS story. Daisy hopes through sharing her journey with PCOS and endometriosis that it will help raise awareness and encourage women to take care of their bodies. Now, a diagnosis of both PCOS and endometriosis is very rare, but it is possible. in a heartfelt post on her Instagram, Daisy talks about how she has been suffering from endometriosis since her diagnosis at the age of 15. She reveals how, this is a quote from an Instagram post, one laparoscopy, many consultations, and 8 years down the line, pain was back, more mild this time, and my skin was the worst. She openly and honestly admits how her skin left her feeling self-conscious and lacking confidence. Daisy explains how she tried everything to help her skin, including products and antibiotics, but nothing worked. Daisy finally found out the reason for her skin problems. It was because of her PCOS. Overcoming PCOS certainly takes time, it's not easy, but Daisy has certainly made significant progress. Through working with a dermatologist and making dietary changes, including cutting out dairy and sugar, she has seen improvements to her skin. To raise further awareness about PCOS and endometriosis, Daisy stresses the importance of getting checked. And this is a quote found from one of her Instagram posts. To any of you who are suffering with anything, go to a doctor, pay for a specialist, get your hormones tested, get allergy tested. Keep on top of how you are and how you and your body is feeling, and don't worry about sounding like a hypochondriac. From your head to the tips of your toes, we only have one body. Let us all make sure ours is working in tip-top condition and take help if it is needed. Celebrities with PCOS may appear to be living this pitch-perfect life, but as Daisy's story clearly shows, they too are human, and they struggle and have imperfections just like we do. Next up on the list is Sonam Kapoor. Sonam, a Bollywood actress, has spoken at length about her journey from dealing with adolescent obesity, battling depression, body image, and overcoming her PCOS. Her journey has been a struggle, to say the least. Celebrities with PCOS have been very open about their lives during interviews, and Sonam is an example of this. In a candid conversation about her weight loss journey, Sonam explains how her battle with her weight began when she was 12 years old. She describes how her weight, unhealthy diet and lifestyle resulted in her suffering various health problems, including diabetes, where she had to take insulin tablets. Doctors diagnosed Sonam with PCOS in her teens. Sonam explains how she gained 35 kilograms in 5 to 6 months and how she began to grow hair in unusual places and also suffered from acne. All these symptoms left Sonam to feel self-conscious and upset. She started dieting to lose weight as a teenager, but exposed to the drastic measures she took, which also landed her in the hospital. The pressure to be thin for films and magazine covers does not always help, but Sonam tries to strive for a healthy balance. Sonam tries to follow a healthy but balanced lifestyle, which means she eats the food she wants without restriction.
Make choices that are good for you.
Yeah.
Even image choices, body choices, if you look into the mirror, you should love yourself. And if you love yourself enough, you will take care of yourself.
She enjoys drinking coconut water and cucumber juice as they boost her energy levels. Sonam's days involve rigorous physical tasks, including dancing, swimming, and therefore eats every 2 hours. As part of her exercise routine, Sonam jogs every morning and also enjoys 30 minutes of Bikram yoga or Pilates. Last but no means least is Jamie King. Jamie is an American actress and model who has spoken about her struggles trying to conceive and hopes that sharing her story will no longer make infertility a taboo topic.
When I would see this picture-perfect thing out in the media, I felt like it was a disservice to other women because it wasn't real. Right. And like everybody is living these very Instagram-perfect lives where everything is curated and filtered, and I don't want to be that for women. I want women to know that I'm there and they're not alone.
In an Instagram post, Jamie spoke of how it took 9 doctors and 8 years of suffering and pain before she received a diagnosis of PCOS and endometriosis. Jamie lived with the pain for so many years because she thought it was normal. It was only until the pain became increasingly worse that she questioned the cause. Further in her Instagram post, Jamie describes the 4.5-year journey she and her husband went through to conceive their first child. After suffering from 5 miscarriages, ectopic pregnancy, and going through 5 rounds of IVF and 26 IUI sessions, Jamie naturally became pregnant with her first son, James, who was born on October 2013. Jamie spoke about her struggle with infertility and her PCOS miscarriage in an interview with Galore and revealed how she felt ashamed of her body. She says that, "I thought that because my womb didn't work the way I was taught it should work, I was broken." Despite her PCOS pregnancy struggles, Jamie conceived her second child naturally and gave birth to Leo in 2015. Jamie voices the importance of visiting a doctor if you're experiencing really painful and long periods. The actress also mentions if you're cramping and have migraines and are sick to your stomach and are generally not well, that's not normal. So that's the end of the video, and to wrap up this video, I just want to leave you with this message. If these celebrities with PCOS can overcome the PCOS and pregnancy struggles, so can you. PCOS affects many women, and when celebrities with PCOS share their story, it raises awareness and spreads the message and encourages all women to seek support. Now, while these celebrities with PCOS share the same diagnosis, they also share the same determination. Now, the right approach will differ from person to person because we're not all the same and it's not one type of PCOS, but we can see that there are some kind of similarities when it comes to living a healthy lifestyle. Making changes to their diet and their exercise routine became a priority for them. So key takeaways from the treatment plans of this celebrity with PCOS include diet is one of the key components here. So following a whole food diet, which means choosing foods which have been minimally processed and are generally free from artificial substances and additives. Second key component is exercise. This is all about finding what works for you. Again, it's about honoring your own hormone imbalance. As a personal trainer, I work with women with PCOS to find the right exercise for them to make sure that they're not making matters worse and just stressing out their body. Third key component is stress. Stress management is crucial. When we're stressed, cortisol levels rise, and this is not conducive to supporting, it does not help balance hormones and reverse the symptoms of PCOS. So it's important to find out what helps you lower your stress, whether it's meditation or long walks in nature or reading a book or whatever it is, find that thing and do it. Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a like, comment, share, and make sure you subscribe for plenty more videos. I'll catch you in the next one.